So, but for some reason on social media, people forget their manners, right? They do. Like, you wouldn't go into a women's networking meeting, for example, and pass out your business cards and say, here's my thing, when are you going to order, how many of these are going to order, did you order yet, right? We don't, human beings don't talk like that, right? But online, people do. I don't know if it's just that the computer is between you and you think, oh, well, I'll just do this, or if it's because you think you're going to post something and then make $1 million. How realistic is that? It's not, right? And so even though I'm a technology trainer, social media trainer, to me, it's really about relationship building using the tool of social media, of technology. In fact, I love doing leader events because when I was a leader in the direct selling company I was with, that is where I felt most fulfilled, was when I started sponsoring and working with leaders under me and honestly changing people's lives. In fact, I wanted to read you something. So I have two books. One is the starter book for representatives. The next one is for leaders. And I wanted to read you a little bit about this because it's a little bit of my, I have a kind of a complicated story which you can read about, but I'll, if I tell it, sometimes I start crying. So I'm just going to read you part of it.
But that would make us be able to relate to you.
I know, I might start crying anyway just reading this. So let me just preface this with, how many of you, now you're all leaders here. Some of you are beginning leaders. Some of you have been doing this for a while, whether with this company or something prior. How many of you feel like you're a completely different person than you were when you first entered direct selling? As far as confidence goes,
oh, yeah.
Right.
Oh, yeah.
So I've always felt like this is a personal development industry, right? We build people. And if you are not maximizing the opportunities to get the word out there about what you have to offer, it's like you're being selfish, keeping this to yourself.
Absolutely.
And so when it comes to social media marketing, that's where I see people missing opportunities. Especially, even if you're doing, like, I feel like I'm doing social media, I'm posting every day, nobody's liking anything, but I'm posting every day, and nobody's doing anything, but I'll just keep posting, so I'm doing social media. If you're doing social media, but you're not touching people's hearts, you are not making a difference. You're transactional. And so what I'm going to be talking about, and I'm going to give you specific examples of how to actually connect with people. And so I won't tell you the whole story, but my life is completely different because of direct selling. People before products, I feel like changes the message that direct sales is giving out. Like, we can uplift the reputation by who we are being on the inside, right? Okay,
so
I'm getting off on a whole nother So, because I want you guys to really get the potential that you have as leaders and using technology. Yes, it's a vehicle to do that. Because it's exponential, the difference you can make. You can only physically meet so many people. Somebody said earlier, I've got so many times, you know, hours in the day. You can only do so many parties physically. But online, average Facebook person has 350 friends. Somebody likes your post, their 350 friends might see it. If they like it enough to share it to their 350 friends, then their 350 friends like it and share it to their, I mean, things go viral. You see that all the time. Why can't that be you? Why can't that be your message and your agent of change in the world? And I really strongly feel this, that people are missing an opportunity, either because they're overdoing it and turning people off, or they're afraid of it and not doing it at all. How many of you have ever felt like you're going to break the internet if you press the wrong button? So nowadays, people are more comfortable with it, but on social media, people are afraid of doing the right thing, or they're afraid they're going to get in Facebook jail or something like that. So they do less than what they could be doing. So what I'm trying to do is teach you everything you need to know in 2 hours, and then hopefully we'll see what a difference you guys can make. And I'm going to keep tracking. Like, I'm going to give you very specific how-tos and some examples. There are some cautions. So we have indirect sales. It's a little bit of a different industry. Like, you, I would really recommend going to like a social media class that's for more enterprise businesses, maybe small business entrepreneur type workshops. But sometimes when you go to classes for regular businesses, it doesn't really apply, because we are not a brand. You are not a brand, although you can brand yourself. You are not promoting a product nearly as much as you're promoting an experience, a lifestyle, a feeling, a community, all of those things you guys have been talking about, what it means to sponsor people. So it's a little bit different. Don't go nuts, less is more. So if any of you guys are fired up after this, you're like, okay, I'm doing social media now. Don't overdo it and be like going nuts, because you'll repel people. You want to compel, you want to draw them into your world, not turn them off. And that can go with over talking. Does anybody have the experience of talking somebody out of the business because you share too much?
Yes.
Okay, so we got this comp plan, and we got this kid, and we got this product, and this problem, this trip, and then they're like, I just want to make some friends. Right? You can talk people out of the business. You want to create curiosity so that they come to you fired up about what you have to offer. So don't, even if you learn what to post, we don't want you to overdo it or share too much. You can kind of throw up on people with words. Mm-hmm. Every single thing, and I heard this earlier, has to be duplicable. Do not go hire a videographer to do your own special videos and a graphic designer to make your graphics all professional, because nobody's going to think they could do your job. I don't care if you can't afford it. You need to make it relatable in every single way so that people who are watching you that you don't even know are considering your opportunity would be like, I could do that. She just goes out there and takes a picture of her in this cute little thing and posts it on Facebook. I could do that. Make it duplicable. And if you're one of the ones that are spending hours and hours on Facebook every day, you might have the time for that, or maybe you figured it out. You know how to manage your time. But the average person sees that and they're like, when did she have a life? I don't want that. So it hurts your recruiting if you are not being duplicable in the time management, in where your priorities are, in the content that you're posting. You want to leverage the tools that you have and be smart about it. So always consider, is this something others could duplicate? Yes, you can teach your team, but you still want to be careful. So let's say you decide you're going to go take a class on how to make videos. And yes, it's a little more higher end than what the average person could do. So you hold a meeting, you teach people how to do that. Still be careful on what it might look like to a non-team member. Because you literally don't know who in your network has been thinking for years, I might do that someday, right? And then something happens, they lose their job, husband gets retrained or whatever. They're like, I'm ready to do that. But they're like, I don't know, I don't have the skills, I'm scared. You want to make it difficult. Follow the rules. So your company, I'm assuming, has rules about what you can and cannot say. Can you say chocolate cures cancer? No, it might, but you can't say that, right? You also have different, like you need to make sure you're identified as an independent curator, those kinds of things. So always stay in compliance. Going back to being duplicable, but also as a leader, you are modeling every single thing that you do. People are going to copy whether you want them to. They copy the bad stuff too. Right? So, like if you stop making calls or you stop doing parties or you stop recruiting, they all stop doing it. It's not like you told them to stop doing it. They just know. They stop doing it. So you always want to be the person you want to bring to your team. Okay? So same thing with following rules. And I went to Catholic school and I'm like, that is like drill. I do not break rules at all. So even online, I'm very particular about things because I don't want to get in trouble, but I don't want to be teaching techniques that will get you guys in trouble, like Facebook jail. Has anybody heard of that?
Yeah. Heard of it.
I'm going to tell you some ways of what you're looking at. So now it's not just Facebook jail. They all have this now, right? They're all using algorithms. They're all, trying to get you to pay for ads and all these different things. So you need to make sure you understand, especially at this level, you guys are business leaders. Take some responsibility to know what the rules are and whether or not what you're doing is in compliance, because you are setting that example for everybody, so I'll help you with that. And then there are unspoken rules, like depending on where you live, things like controversial topics like football could be alienating sometimes, just that topic. So like you wouldn't talk about, you wouldn't use like bad words and, for business, right? The way you dress, those kind of things, the professionalism. It's etiquette. It's like in real life, just ask yourself, would I do this? Would I say this? Would I be this way? Would I put this trashy picture on my wall in my house? Why am I putting it on my Facebook? Because you think it's funny. Well, you're a professional. Everything, it doesn't matter.